Well, hi, it's Teresa with Cruising with the Clarks, and today we are going to be cruising into actually it's a carport find. I can't call it a barn find because we didn't find it in a barn, but we did find it under a carport, and it is a 2006 Chevy Colorado. And she's kind of seen her better days. She's not bad though, considering what she's been through. She came from Connecticut. She's a little bit dirty, but that's all right. Yeah, you saw me, I'm a mess. What's we got in the bed back here? We got a battery, it's dead. Oh, a jack stand, another battery. Toys. She's a bit rusty. What do we got down here? Oh. Crunchy, oh. Yeah, don't push too hard. You'll push your finger right through it. Well, she's a 4x4. Which is pretty good. I like that. She's got her original wheels. She's got all-terrain tires on her, which seem to still have a decent bit of tread left on them. She's been parked now for about 2 years, but as you can tell, she came out of Seymour, Connecticut. Got her scratches and her dings, and she's got the tow and hitch. Need that. She's 4x4, the LT flavor. Got a little puncture wound back here. She was a lot dirtier when we brought her home, but we've had about 3 or 4 inches of rain since getting her brought over to the house. And I'm gonna tell you, if I could get under there, if it wasn't so wet, you'd see a lot more rust than you do now. She's a rusty little girl. This side looks better as far as the rust goes. Craigslist side. So we haven't given her a bath. Haven't done much in the way of cleaning her out. So she's gonna need a good one. She has got the IFAP 5-cylinder inside her. Now I would start her up, but as you can see, we don't have a battery. And well, I've got two back there, but neither of them work. And the one battery we do have that does work, we started her up, we did, but she purrs like a jackhammer. And she was, when I said she was from Connecticut, she's been, she was there most of her life, so that's accounting for all the rust. And she has been in Georgia for 4 years. She was, drove for 2 years, and she sat for 2 years. And she's a pretty good girl. While she was there, she's clean. Nice interior. We got the real tree seats. She came with some new windshield wipers. And you can see she's even rusty on the inside. Carpet needs a real good cleaning. She's a rusty little girl. She's got rust even here on the where the seats bolt in. We're gonna have a hard time getting those seats out to really give her a clean. The dash is in excellent condition. For an 06, she's got 193,000 miles. But when we started her up, oh, she just purrs like a jackhammer. And that's one of the reasons why I don't want to start her up again. We managed to drive her home and scared to death doing it. I guess somebody might have thought about tinting the windows and changed their mind, thought better of it. What we got back here in the back seat? I don't know. Let's see. There's some blackjack caulking. A couple of little baby seats for little tiny people. And somebody has lost their sock. Why would they leave one sock? I don't know. She was full of spiders and spider webs and every other thing known to man. So she's been discombobulated. Wonder what they left me in the console. Whee! Oh, a pair of cheap sunglasses. You know, everybody loves cheap sunglasses. That's seen its better day, but I bet I can fix that right up. It's all crunchy. A Walgreens receipt and five pennies and a fuse. What we got in here? Ooh, all kinds of stuff. All kinds of stuff. A bulb. So they've changed a bulb in here somewhere. We have the original book. I'm not going to show any of this because it's got personal information on it. They had some gecko insurance. Lots of bulbs. Yeah, we got that too. And they just pulled that completely out. Oh, and a letter. I wonder if she works. Let's see. Oh, I'm always looking for a lighter. But at least she didn't stink. They had loaded it down with air fresheners when they parked it, so she smelled pretty good. Gonna have to fix that. That's gonna need it. It's got a mirror. Yay! Oh, that one too. It's all plasticky. That's gonna have to be recovered. Gonna have to be recovered. Got a bandana on there. American flagism. That's gonna have to be taken down. For sure. Okay, well, that's about it. I gave you the walk around, little tour, and we know, will it run? It will start, it will run, but it won't drive because she, like I said, she purrs like a jackhammer. And she's gonna need some serious work to make her roadworthy. But she has been rescued. And I'm going to do everything I can, along with my partner in crime. Well, obviously it's been left on the side of the road because there's a note saying being picked up in the door over here. And we'll have more on this 06 Chevy Colorado as things progress and we start picking up parts to take her apart and see what we can do. We're going to pull the motor on her and get her a going. But this is her and gonna love it, I think, once we get her fixed. If anybody has any tips or suggestions on what you think we should do for the massive amount of rod knocking that we've got, just give us a holler. Leave it in the comments below. Hey, Dalton. Help! Check out Dalton with Pogue Barn Garage. He does a lot of rebuilds and restores, and he's really good. Got a great channel. He's funny. Works with his kid a lot, and it's an amazing channel. We love watching him. So check him out. I'll leave a link to his channel for you. And anyway, leave comments on what you think we can do about this motor that knocks so bad that it just can't be driven. What would you do with a Chevy Colorado that you just got, that you gotta do all this work on? And we'll talk to you soon. Peace out, everybody. Bye.